very sad indeed. And what makes it even more sad is the fact that we've seen it several times. The way we are living, the way we are doing things, it just moving us gradually into disaster. Just about 6 or so hours of heavy rain over 2 days, and the whole place is flooded. It's not just flooded, millions of people displaced, and we have 150 and more people dying needlessly. It is very sad. We didn't have to do this to ourselves.
Terrible tragedy. This has happened because certain things have not been done. We should return to those things and just implement and enforce. We are dealing with some real problems here. The way we occupy every conceivable space. They don't leave anything for anybody anywhere. Where the rain can stay and bit here, where children can go to a park, nothing. Everybody is desperate, rat race. We all must get something. We're all in Accra. This will kill us.
We've come to Soweto. We are in the Ga Central Municipality. As you know, this is one of the areas badly affected by the floods. So we've come to talk to the chief executive about exactly what happened and what they are doing to tackle this problem.
We did experience from last year. Though last year we suffered some casualties, I think it was only 2. This time around the casualties was 5. And the displacement was enormous. The volume of the rain is a bit higher. And I think that the situation got worse because people were just dumping waste in the drains. And most of the drains also got choked.
You are the man in charge of this area, and you are telling me about people putting rubbish in drains and all that. Is that not your job to prevent that or clean that?
We do find them. Unfortunately, being a new assembly, we don't have a court. We have to prosecute through the courts of sister assemblies. And because we don't have a prosecutor, normally, something like last year, we prosecuted about 18 people. Unfortunately, only 6 of them were convicted of fines. Because we don't have a court of our own, and then the prosecution is not adequate, we couldn't really have convictions.
Zai, can we fix this problem?
Well, we can fix it. The how is one. We have to stop Germanica, and we have to let the authorities, like the assemblies, enforce the law to the letter. So everybody in position of trust must be allowed to do its work, to enforce the law.
But just do your work. Why do you want to be allowed to do your work? That's why you're there.
Like I said, we try to do our work, but occasionally we are not allowed. People call us with threats. And at times the threat even goes beyond what we can comprehend, because your job is at stake.
The chief executive of the municipality is now going to take us to some of the worst affected areas so we can see exactly what happened.
Should we go?
So we've come to Awoshi with the chief executive. Apparently 3 people died here. They were carried away by the waters. I'm just going to have him tell us exactly what has happened here. Can you explain what you were saying to me, sir?
Yeah, this stream is coming all the way from Ufako.
Right.
And if you look at the stream, like I told you earlier on, look at the garbage. All these are man-made garbages.
This stuff is all
garbage. Yes, which is blocking the flow of water through the culverts.
So the water cannot pass. So did it come above this?
Yes, that's how it carried people off. But people who were, I think 2 of them were trying to cross this bridge.
Yeah.
And the water carried them.
In vehicles or walking?
No, in walking.
And the water took them,
yes, took them off.
To that side?
Yes. I think one was deposited and one was deposited at the other end. Now look at the garbage level. That's what I'm talking about. You see, this is the garbage that blocks the water.
Yeah.
My problem with this thing is that, unfortunately, I don't know which engineer did this. Now, if you look at the quantum of water that is coming.
Yeah.
We don't need this smaller culvert.
So only those 2 are supposed to carry all the water.
So the water overflows and goes to all these homes. Because this place, the water path has been narrowed into a culvert right from here to about 400 meters.
So So it's almost like an engineering deficiency.
Yes, we have to break this. We need to break this and widen up the water path. But like I told you, you see, parts of this place are supposed to be wetlands.
That's it. So these places should not be inhabited.
Exactly.
In the first place. Because these are actually wetlands.
If you look at the texture of the soil, you will see for yourself.
Yeah.
If it were to be not a wetland, by this time, at least it should be dried.
That's it. Ibinom says there, a wati. Or your wetland. Or your baby all the water.
Nkrofoma da woroma. Ni wo mema yendo she ho. Odi yentwai.
Wo di won twensu.
Meka chere mu nebe.
Nti be me gine nti nti chere be me gine nchensu nsu ba fama.
Ka no de ka on ya sem papa. Wo me bi wa ha. Sa nsu fa. Abranti bi su twa nsu fa. 3 years old child nsu fa. Asem osi ha no mu nebe yin se gina ha. Na sem abeki aje.
This is one of the people that died, that the water took away. Clearly, he must have been walking around here somewhere. And as the waters came, it just, you know, blew him away. A 30-year-old guy, Moses Ankra. Terrible shame. Do you know him?
Yes, I know him.
Yeah.
He's a guy in the neighbor who comes to fix our generator.
Right.
So on that bad day, he was passing. He was coming from town
right.
When he was trying to cross the flood. So one of my sisters saw him and told him, Aberu, don't go. The flood is too mad. You can't cross the flood.
He was trying to cross the road
yes.
And go across.
Yes. So when he got to this place, he met about 4 guys together with him, making 5. They held their hands together, trying to cross it. But when they got to the middle of the flood, they could not. So they had to split. The next morning, we heard our barrel was dead.
So all this is part of Ablekuma?
Yeah. This place is called Odunj.
Okay.
Odunj.
They constructed a pitch.
Open it wide. For water to come. Yet, they didn't know where the water is going.
Oh, you mean this water is just...
It's just going nowhere.
Wow.
It's just going nowhere. A lot of houses.
They just put it there and leave it. So they left it for the water to go nowhere. And like I told you, you see, in the dry times, it's flowing very slowly, very small in volumes.
Yeah.
But when it rains, the whole place...
So this carries huge water,
yes.
That's it.
That's why they made it big.
And where is this water going?
Nowhere. Yeah, it's finding its way in people's homes.
So, where we saw the bridge,
yes.
All the water comes from there.
Comes from there and end up here. It's washing everything here. Creating its own part because they just left it, causing all this damage, and it's going further down.
So
causing more damage down this.
And this is somebody's house,
yeah, which collapsed.
This house, the children.
There were children in this house.
Yes.
And there's a school right here, by the way.
Yes. There are 2 schools.
See, have you seen that?
I have called the whole thing. This building.
Here. Yeah.
Yes, there's a road coming from that place. And he said he has got permit. And so he has blocked this thing that there's no road here. Who gave him the permit? Nobody knows.
He got a permit from Kassat. We are investigating his permit.
So you believe that if they had demolished those buildings,
this area, we don't have any access road. If there is any emergency, we don't have any access road.
Right.
Those living here, we have to park our cars at the filling station and walk. When we came here, this is the access road for all of us.
Right.
We pass here to our houses.
Driving.
Driving. Yeah. But because of these buildings and, madam, and their culverts.
Madam, let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
When this man was putting up this building, where were you?
We wrote letters.
Letters and this thing.
See, that's part of the problem.
You see, I agree, but my problem, no, no, you wrote letters to the assembly.
Yes.
Hold on. Yeah. The assembly wasn't doing anything.
Yeah.
You have a community. You always march to the assembly. Why didn't you march to him?
We couldn't.
Hey, we couldn't.
So can you do something about it? You are the chief of
the front. We have to
before we come in, I want to ask him what he's going to do.
We have to break it. Let's say we have to break it.
Yes. Yeah.
It's also not lawful.
Yes.
What is not lawful?
Breaking it.
Breaking the house that is sitting on the road.
If he genuinely has a permit, as to whether he's sitting on the road, I can't say.
That's the trouble.
Hold
you
on.
See. Yeah.
Because there is a layout.
That's it. The special planning.
We don't have the layout.
So you don't even know whether it's really on the road.
Exactly. And we need to be sure about the layout.
Yeah.
And investigate whether it's a road.
So
like
do you have access to that? The plan for the area. I mean, you are the chief executive. Yeah, do you have access to that?
At the time the thing came.
Yeah.
We don't have the layout.
There was no layout, or you didn't have the layout?
There was no layout for the whole of Ablikuma. So we are now acquiring the layout.
Yeah.
So when we acquire the layout, we will investigate.
So when you say layout, you mean where houses are, where roads are?
Where houses should be, where roads should be, and all that.
That
wasn't any layout.
Wow. Can you imagine this is not that? The first time I'm explaining. Where the roads are, where the people reside.
This is not the first time I have to explain this.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
Madam, verify things. I send them to come and mark it.
Yes.
Hold on. And you don't even understand. You don't even understand.
Yeah.
Accusing me will not solve your problem.
But imagine.
Hold on. I send them to come and mark.
Yes.
At the time I send them to come and mark.
Yes.
I didn't come and I thought he hasn't got a permit. Like most of them here.
Yes.
Most people here don't have permit, yes, and that's the truth.
That's correct.
So I thought he hasn't got permit,
yes,
like
correct.
Most of them here.
Yeah, correct.
Correct.
Yeah, correct.
He brought his permit.
Yes, correct.
Now, if somebody, assuming the person have a permit, if he hadn't got the permit, like by this time this is gone,
yes,
I would demolish it because I have grounds.
Yes.
No permit him. But he brought his permit. Now, if somebody brings a permit given by another local authority, I cannot run quickly and demolish it.
Yes.
The law doesn't give me that power.
Should be okay.
We have to investigate.
Yeah.
And ensure the dimensions of the permit. This school is also supposed to be on the road.
Yes.
So the school is actually also sitting on the road.
Yes. I brought the consultant, the urban roads engineer, the resident engineer here.
Yes.
And they went back, prepared quantities for us. The assembly was even prepared to support them. So what authority do they need?
So what has happened? So why is it
now,
not so?
This, now,
yes,
what
right
are
now?
We going to
all they are
yes,
doing
right
is,
now, what do we do?
All they are doing is pass the back.
Okay.
Now,
we can't have, we work from the ground to the top.
Correct.
But this thing was caught from the
point.
It was caught from the top.
For us to go to the...
Wait. It was caught from top to the down.
Yes, so we...
Let me tell you something. Let me tell you the truth, the basic truth. You people don't even understand the little bit of politics, and that is what is really annoying me. When we came here, we were in your house.
Yes.
We were in your house. Did you hear what the minister said? He said that this is solve it. How am I going to solve this thing? Tell me.
Yes, that was... The
incident happened.
No, how? Tell me. Do you think if the assembly has money to resolve this, I wouldn't do it?
You will do it. Because you are forcing your... Always you have been coming here.
That is when they brought the quotations, they brought the quantities.
Yeah.
I approved it. Has it been done?
Yes. No.
So if I write, would it be done?
No.
Let's be realistic. Yeah. Not only this, all these people. Now, in case it's raining, where are they going to be?
So there's no access to your...
No access!
No, there's no access now.
Wait, what, you're going through...
You have to go down before you go up.
Listen, all of us, yeah.
That's how you access your home?
Yes.
By walking through this?
Yes.
I know.
You have to climb.
Yeah, you have to climb. Come on, we have some signs here.
Wow. So the people that live here, I mean, this is how they access their house because of what has happened here. To access their homes, they have to climb this wall and go home. You climb over the wall to go home?
Yeah.
Because of this?
Yes.
And so when you're going out, what do? You climb like this to go out?
I have this thing here so that I won't get smashed.
So you don't hurt yourself. Is that what everybody has to do?
Of course.
So how is your mother? That's your grandmother?
And she said, that's just a walk of you. Eh? Walk of one. Ah, 70. Wow. And so you've heard the heated argument between the municipal chief executive of Gas Central and, you know, the people of Awoshi. A big discussion about whether houses should be demolished, whether they should be there. And we couldn't even tell whether the houses were situated on roads or not. The big issue was spatial planning. As you heard, the chief executive said there was no layout, so it's hard for him to even say whether the house is sitting on a road or not. So we've come to town and country planning, those who are responsible for spatial planning, for deciding where everything sits in space, to find out what they're doing to ensure that many of these areas of Ghana have actually got spatial plans with which to develop. So I walked into his office, and then here before me is even a layout of part of Tsuntum where you went this morning. And it's all laid out very nicely. Can you explain to me, Mr. Kodoyeboa, what all of this is and why this is not what is on the ground?
The implementation is the key issue, because we don't own the land. And before you realize, the chief, they have gone to sell even area that you have marked, you have earmarked for refuse. When we prepared this scheme, ideally, we should have constructed the roads. We should have pillaring all the, you know, the plots, so that when you go to the site, you know that this is a road and don't have to bathe on the road. But unfortunately, we don't do this implementation on the ground. So people will go to the ground and then they will bathe as
anyhow. So this becomes useless.
So eventually, they don't follow this. So that is the critical issue that we have.
Is it too late to follow this?
I don't think it is too late. But the issue is that it has been approved.
But why is it not too late? If they've already built all, if the whole place is built up and you say it's not too late?
It is built up, but we need to enforce it.
So enforcing meaning that if a house is sitting in the refuse place, you must break it?
Yes. Because it is serving a purpose and we need that purpose. Because the community interest supersedes the individual interest.
Precisely. This fascinates me. This is Accra Kole Lagoon Recreational Area Planning Scheme. And essentially, this is today, we call this Sodom and Gomorrah. Are you telling me, Chief, that instead of what we have there today, this is what was supposed to be there?
This is where we have the Central Mosque.
Ah, so this is the mosque area.
Yeah, and then International Central Gospel Church.
So that's the main road leading to the Kolebo.
Yes, this is the main road leading to Kolebo.
And so this is the Kole Lagoon.
The channel. So you could see the channel. You could see the buffer that we earmark.
When you say buffer, you mean the amount of space between the buildings and the water. So we have built almost all into the water.
Everything. You see here, we propose a stadium for this area. And this is where now the Sodom and Gomorrah is.
So this is where the people are living.
Yeah, this is where they are living. And we propose all this place as a recreational area by building even a stadium, another stadium here.
And they've put sawdust in the water
filled all of this place.
With
sawdust. And they have built on this. Almost everything is gone here.
Wow.
So people will always say, Accra is not well planned. To me, we planned Accra very well, but we haven't built Accra well.
Well, I think that really sums it up, doesn't it? You said it all. If we don't sort out the way we organize ourselves, where we live, and simply follow the rules, we're going to run into deep trouble. Next year, the rains will come again. Year after year, the rains come, and we have floods and people die. There is no reason for it. So hopefully, some of these plans we see will come to fruition in the future.